We begin with leaders' questions, and before I call on Deputy Micheál Martin, I want to remind those involved that there's 2 minutes to present your question, 3 minutes to the Taoiseach to reply, 1 minute for a supplementary on both sides. Thank you. Deputy Martin.
Thank you, Micheál Coghlan. Taoiseach, last week you said that the European Union deal was unique to Greece and it did not harm Ireland and did no damage. This was despite making pre-election promises about burning bank bondholders and then subsequently doing nothing about it. Your party and the Labour Party spent months promising the people that you would burn bank bondholders, yet you, Taoiseach, did not even put this issue on the negotiating table. This is in sharp contrast to your pre-election promises and indeed to commitments that were made by you and your Minister for Finance to mark your 100 days in office. In June, Minister Noonan announced that the government's intentions in New York not to give another cent to the banks without burden sharing with senior bondholders. Minister Noonan described Anglo as a warehouse, as it receives no deposits or gives out loans. These bank bondholders were not part of the EU-IMF deal or indeed of any guarantee, yet you're planning to sign off on the $775 million today. And it's worth pointing out, Taoiseach, that Fine Gael and Labour promises to burn these bondholders actually drove down the price of those bonds. And investors who bought these bonds will have doubled their money in the past 9 months on the basis of the commitments that you gave. The new government can hardly complain about speculators making money from these bonds, since it was your empty promises that drove down the price and created the opportunity for these gains. Last December, Minister Noonan spoke about the obscene situation where the poorest of the poor, through taxes and welfare cuts, have been asked to guarantee the speculation of investors in hedge funds. And he declared that Ireland has no moral or legal obligation to cover this debt. Yet this is exactly what he intends to do today. Taoiseach, you have failed to deliver.
Question, please.
Failed even to put the issue on the negotiating
question,
table.
Please. You're
do
over
you
time.
Now, Taoiseach, regret
you're,
making...
You're over time, Deputy. Would you put the question?
No.
Will you put the question, please?
In short, Taoiseach, do you regret misleading the Irish people on this very specific issue?
Taoiseach. Taoiseach to reply. 3 minutes, Taoiseach.
I want to thank Deputy Martin for the history lesson. You left out some of the important bits. First thing is that politics is never a case of swanning around making easy decisions. The situation in this country was clarified by the people last February when they gave this government, comprised of the Fine Gael and Labour parties, the largest majority in the history of the state, to pursue a policy of growth and not default. That's the first point. The second point on looking at the books as we find them is that $17 billion had been paid to bondholders in Anglo-Irish by the previous government. Now, I want to say this to you, Deputy Martin. I want to say this to you directly. I'd love to stand up here and say it's not necessary to pay this money. But we made a case to the European Central Bank when I spoke to Mr. Trisha and myself in March when we were considering bondholders and the other Irish banks. It was not possible to get the consent and the agreement of the European Central Bank, as you're aware. 17 governors make up their minds in this regard. And when Minister Noonan spoke on a number of occasions and negotiated with Mr. Trichet about the question of bondholders in Anglo, the European Central Bank would not give their agreement. So I admit that it has not been possible for this government to unravel the agreement that was made by your government with our external parties. That's the first thing. And following that, I want to say that we have pursued an alternative policy of having the debt burden reduced. And if this government...
Please be seated.
If the government had defaulted on these bonds, Minister, we would not have had the support of our colleagues to get a $10 billion reduction in interest rates.
Thank you. You have 1 minute. Thank you.
Taoiseach, every member of this government, including yourself and those sitting behind you, every member was elected on a commitment not to pay the full $700 million the Anglo bondholders are being repaid today. And you can dress up your position. You can dress up your position in all of the brazen nonsense you want.
I'll read it out to you.
You can't wriggle out, Taoiseach, of your own clear words. In fact, the value of the bond collapsed in February as a result of Fine Gael and Labour statements and commitments. And since then, Taoiseach, you have done absolutely nothing to implement your commitments. And it's incredible the length that you've actually gone not to burn these bondholders.
I have your supplementary
I didn't ask you to stand. You actually stood up yourself, Taoiseach, on many occasions, on many a platform, saying you would not pay these particular bondholders. At the four crisis summits you have attended, Taoiseach, you did not table any measure to allow the burning of these bondholders. You did not meet Mr. Trichet about it. You did not meet Mr. Draghi about it when you were appointing him as the ECB president. And you did not raise it with your close friend, Chancellor Merkel. You made a solemn promise, Taoiseach, of not another red cent more. And if you were told in March...
Could I have your supplementary question, please?
...New York telling the world that he wasn't going to pay these particular bondholders.
Thank you.
He told RTE for the world. The guts to say to Geithner, who we met on that particular occasion, Taoiseach, everything you see in here means absolutely nothing.
Would you please resume your seat?
Your words mean nothing in here.
Thank you. I don't know what the question is, but let me reply, Taoiseach. Could we do without the chorus for a minute, please? Thank you.
Cancola, there is no question in Deputy Martin's comments. I could remind him that he was not present at any of the discussions the four meetings have attended. You weren't present at the discussions I had with either Chancellor Merkel or Mr. Trichet. Now, I know that the... I know that the Fianna Fáil party in the past had ways of finding out what people were saying when they weren't supposed to be listening. We remember that in this house before. But I want to remind Deputy Martin of this. You know, when we found it was not possible to unravel the agreement that your government made with our external partners, we pursued an alternative strategy. The first thing I want to say is that any comment I've made on this was on the basis of not committing another cent to Anglo-Irish Bank beyond what was already committed. They haven't asked for any more money, and they're not getting any more money than has already been committed.
Thank you, Taoiseach. We're
Secondly,
over time. Thank you.
We would not have got a 10 billion reduction in interest rate appreciation if we had defaulted. We would not have got long-term guarantees of the money. We would not have got the support of our colleagues. And I'll put it this way here, and I'll finish on this account, Corley.
Thank you.
What's required here, Deputy Martin, is a clear head, is the retention of our confidence and our reputation. We are not going to scuttle this ship while there are challenging waters ahead, because we know we're proceeding with our reputation enhanced. Ireland always pays its way, and while I don't like to have to do this, in the interests of our people and the long-term future of our country, we cannot unpick what you did. We're pursuing alternative strategies to have the debt burden reduced.